introduce what the object. My name is Lily. This is our group member.
Yeah, my name is Esther.
And one the photographer, Aiko. And today we will introduce one the piano. It named Butterfly Piano. And it was made in 1940, and it was also being modified by the Granger and Cross in 1982.
Oh, Lily, after we have a quick look at this object, how would you like to describe this object?
Well, as we can see from the piano, it was made by emerald, wood, steel, ivory, ebony, and nails. And I think the reason why he made the modified it is he want to make the maximization of the music, and he wants audience to like listen to music by their heart, and he also want like attract audience by this piano, through this music.
You have just covered the characteristics and its purpose and use.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Aiko.
Hi, Aiko. I want to ask you, what culture and time period does the object belong to? And do you think the object has historical or cultural significance?
Just like Lily mentioned, this object was made in 1940, and I do think it has its own historical significance. It is because that this butterfly piano was turned in 1/6 tone, so playing on it would produce a wave-like gliding tone effect. Hi, Isabel. What's your emotional response to this object?
Okay, when it comes to instruments, I just pictured my accordion. You know, I used to learn how to play accordion when I was 30 years old, when I was at my 9th grade. And during that period of time, I was really into it. But due to the heavy learning tasks, my mom asked me to give up the accordion and focus my attention on my studies. So when I recall back that memory, I think it's really a huge pity. So if I have opportunities in the future, I really want to study how to play piano or accordion or some other instruments in the future. To conclude, we really enjoyed ourselves in this event.